We live on a really dynamic planet. Elegant, fragile, precious. It's our house. It's our home, it's our community. That is what this little blue ball is. So the reason we should all care is it's the only home we have.
I think the most important thing to keep in mind today is that the climate is changing and people are already experiencing those impacts.
Climate change is the melting glaciers, it's the melting ice caps, it is the rising sea level, it's the extremes in temperature that we have.
As the Earth gets warmer and warmer, we get more droughts and more floods. We get more storms.
I mean, Hoboken was devastated by Hurricane Sandy. 80% of our city was underwater.
Climate change is in effect the result of the society we've had, which would imply if we continue with the society we have, climate change will be with us for a long time, and that's not a good thing.
This is not about any one country. It is a global issue.
It's about people's lives, people's livelihood.
We all should care about this. It's the one shared environmental global phenomenon.
This is a global issue. It's about the community of nations on this planet. And it's important for leading nations to be in a leading position on these issues. The president's climate policies have certainly helped move the United States forward on many fronts, from carbon mitigation to energy efficiency to adaptation and resilience.
I have been amazed over the last 40 years that I've been involved in this, or 39 to be exact, as to the progress we've made.
We're really working on reducing the amount of greenhouse gases. The gases that trap heat and everything into our atmosphere and cause these extremes in climate that we see.
We are making the commitment we need to engage every country to step up and work with us so that we can chart a path to a low carbon future.
We need to move towards a clean energy future. President Obama has promoted renewable energy. He's promoted energy efficiency. He's promoted a range of policies that help us get past the problem of global warming while growing our economy.
The world is investing over $300 billion a year in clean energy worldwide right now.
Wind power, electric vehicles, solar power.
Every 4 minutes, a house or a building goes solar.
For the first time in 2014, we saw economic growth grow globally and concentrations of greenhouse gases did not grow.
Pollution shouldn't be thought of after the economic development. It should actually be ingrained in how you develop.
If you're making that investment, you know, up front, then in the long run, there will be investment in your region.
It's really time to lean forward into what the future is going to be and think ahead about the conditions your investments will need to survive in and thrive in 10, 20, 30 years down the road. Take the longer view and build resilient now. Build more energy efficient now. Build less carbon intensive now. Get ahead of the curve.
We know that climate change is real. We know that it's impacting us, and we also know that there are solutions that we can bring to the table that will benefit all of us.
This is a global problem that requires a global solution.
We can get this done, and we can get it done in a way that every country can embrace.
We understand what's happening. We understand the problem. And as the young kids would say today, I'm on it.